Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Vieco. So, I'm gonna be talking about something scary, and that's AI. To be precise, the evolution of AI. So the evolution of AI is gotten pretty crazy lately. And last year I did the video on Rodin. Rodin is that website that generates 3D models based off images or just prompt texts. And Rodin was in beta back then, and now Rodin is out of beta. Not only that, their generative model is upgraded from version 1.0 to 1.5, meaning it's more precise, more sharp, more detailed. Plus, they added a couple of extra features, and it's like it was crazy back then. Now it's just, I don't know. See for yourself. So for those of you who didn't watch my previous video, I'm just gonna roughly go through Rodin on how it works, and then I'm gonna cover these new cool features, and that's the bounding box control net mode, voxel control net mode, and point cloud control net mode. So yeah, buckle up. So this is pretty much how Rodin works. You click on this first option, and here you can add a text input or you can add an image. So if I click on the little plus here, and if I add an image of a chicken like this, like a toy chicken, and if I hit generate, now this is what you get. This is the model of this is a preview model of that little toy chicken. You can add prompts here if you want to regenerate it to, you know, add some other stuff. If you don't like how the model turns out, you can always click the redo button. So when it comes to modifying whatever you are kind of generating with Rodin, the modifications, it's all cost free until you're satisfied. Once you're satisfied with your object, then you're going to have to pay in the form of some credits. By the way, if you go to Rodin website and if you hover with your mouse here, you can click on the code redemption and you can enter this code and you're going to get 10 credits for free. Just remember, if you already used a code like this on your account, it will not work. Other than that, the code will be in the description of the video, so you can just copy paste it from there. And this is the result that I got. So I got these chickens with these weird freckles here. But once you're satisfied with your object, you just hit the confirm button. Additionally, you can always go to history and see all the versions that you redid on the whole chicken. Now, when you hover over the confirm button, you can see that if you want to go to the pro mode or with the quad mesh mode. Quad mesh mode is going to give you nice topology. Pro mode is this super triangulated mode. And what pro mode is, why is it actually called pro mode? Because that's like a raw data that's being exported from the AI. The quad mesh is pretty much the retopology, like automatic retopology done on the object. So I'm gonna go with quad mesh because this is, for example, a prop in my scene, and I'm gonna go with, let's say, 18,000 polygons, and I'm gonna hit okay. You saw that it says that it costs 0.5 credits. Now picture this, last year, any sort of generation plus texturing would cost about 3 to 4 credits. Now they reduced the price to 0.5 credits for everything, like modeling and texturing. And this is the model that I currently got. You can go here and you can check the wireframe to see how it all looks like. You can now click generate and generate this yellow chicken. Or you can click the plus button, load in a plushy toy of a gremlin and hit generate, and you're gonna get this gremlin looking chicken. That's how it works. Once you're happy, you can click confirm. You can choose your formats. Do you want to go with 2K textures, 4K textures? Just hit download and import your little gremlin chicken to your Max. Here next to it, I have a different generation of that same chicken that I did, and it's pretty much me redoing the material, you know, a couple of more times until I got a funky result. But once you start your render, you can, you know, create this little gremlin chicken army in your scene. On the left, I have the 50,000 polygon mesh. On the right, I have the 18,000 polygon mesh. So as you can see, it looks pretty decent. Now you can write prompts and say, I don't know, a funky dog, hit okay. And he's gonna create some funky dogs for you. And you can now, you know, generally create 3D models from that. One funky being that I created from just a prompt is this little dude. One thing that you can notice here, if you take a look at the glasses actually have thin elements on them. Previously, glasses like these would actually be kind of merged to the whole face, like you would not see it as detailed as you do now. Additionally, if you go to the coat, you can even see the thickness of the inside of the coat. These things were not like this before. This would all be merged together. But now let's check those control net features. Control net features are crazy. So look at this. You have the bounding box, voxel, and the point cloud. So for the bounding box, let's say that my client sent me an image of this bed and he wants me to add this bed to my scene, right? I can now grab these two images. I can drop them here. I'm gonna go to the bounding box and I'm gonna click handcraft. So bounding box, what is that? That's pretty much the outer shape, the outer dimension of the model you're going to generate. It's pretty much a box. You just set up how high it is, wide, long, etc. So you can upload a 3D model of a box or a 3D model of an actual bed and he's going to turn it into a box. But for this example, I'm going to click on handcraft, and here I know that the width of my bed is 160, height is 100, and length is 200. So I'm just going to hit confirm here, generate, and now I need to choose if I want to go with multiview or fusion. Multiview means that you can upload multiple images that are showing at the same thing, and Rodin will know that those images are related. They're, he's going to know that they are from this, kind of the same space, if you know what I mean. Fusion, on the other hand, he treats two different images. By the way, you can upload up to 5 images. Fusion will treat all those images as separate worlds. So if you import a T-Rex in a butterfly image, he's gonna fuse those two together into a scary butterfly with T-Rex jaws and head. So for this example, I'm gonna go with multi-view. And I got this. This is pretty much my bed. So if I confirm this, my model is looking like this. And if I confirm this as my material, you get this. There you go. A little bit crazy, huh? But now, speaking of crazy, I got this image as a blueprint for the chair. Like, no joke, this was for the actual project. And I got this side view. And I was instructed that I need to model this chair. So I figured out that this is actually a very good test for Rodin to see how it will perform on something like this. I know the dimensions of these chairs, but I'm not gonna tell them to Rodin. So I'm gonna grab these two images, toss them in, and I'm going to be in the regular mode, and I'm going to hit generate multi-view. Let's see, Rodin, how you deal with an example like this. Okay. Yeah, this is an excellent base for me to start modeling. It's easier to start modeling from something like this rather than, these crappy blueprint images. Now for the voxel mode. Get this. I have a picture of this sofa in this angle and this angle. So quarter view, front and side, right? What I also did, I modeled this sofa like this. So this is like a 3-minute modeling work. I'm gonna go to the voxel mode, click on upload, load in my sofa and see what happens. It kind of looks like, like a set of blocks. The only thing that I need to just do is kind of correctly rotate it. So if I go to the X position and here I can rotate it, you can also see the preview of your model. You just kind of want it to look correct. I'm gonna confirm that. I'm gonna grab those three images and I'm gonna drop them here and I'm gonna hit generate and I'm gonna use the multi-view. And this is what I got. It's pretty much that sofa. So now if I hit confirm, maybe should have confirmed it with 50,000 polygons instead of 18, but yeah, okay, let's see what happens. We got this thingy, just gonna click on generate to get the materials, and this is it. A little bit crazy, huh? We also have the point cloud mode. It's pretty much for you to import 3D scans in it, and it's going to retopologize them, regenerate them. So you can, test out point cloud on your own. I don't have any 3D scans near me right now. So if you decide to give Rodin a go, if you go here, you can see all the payment methods. So you can buy credits, but of course, the most affordable thing is to buy a monthly subscription because it's cheaper and it gives you 30 credits where you can generate around 60 assets with those 30 credits. But a cool thing is you can go and refer for free credits. So what does that mean? Whenever you wanna, tell somebody about Rodin, you can just, everyone will get their own link here. So you can just click this, copy this link, send it to a friend, and if he buys credits with this link, look what happens. Refer users to our service and they get 50% extra credits on their first payment, excluding the free trial, plus you score 25% of their paid credits too. So the more people you refer it to, you're pretty much becoming a Rodin credit god. There is many more crazy stuff about Rodin. For example, if you become a subscriber and if you go to the Omnicraft here, you see HDRI generation, all these texture generations, HDRI generations, those are all free tools for subscribers where you can generate HDRIs. So look at this. Here, I generated these three HDRIs. And when you click them, this is the thing that you generated. And you can use it in your scene. For example, the scene that I have here has that same HDRI loaded in. And yeah, look, it works. it's crazy, yeah. You get free HDRI generators, texture generators, much more things. So yeah, check out Rodin. It's very fancy. It is. See you in the next video. Bye.